So what happens now? There are a couple of rescues on Kos, hey? You know the names, and many of them are castrating. We do that with the local vet. There are 5 vets on Kos. Nicole and me, we are also every week we go out to catch cats for castrations. But it's too much work, also for the rescues and also for the vets. The vets are working extra hours, they are tired, and it's too much. There are so many cats on Kos. So what happens, especially now in this season, a lot of kittens are born. They are dumped everywhere. As you see on this place, Asclepion, I think it's one of the most important archaeological touristic places on Kos. And this is what tourists see if they come here to Asclepion. This is not what you want your tourists to see. We talked about that with the municipality. They are aware of the problem, but they haven't done anything so far. But this is not the only place. There are more places like this on Kos, behind the Agora, where you find the Vodafone. It's a similar thing. Volunteers, just people like us, local people who have jobs, go there every day to feed them and to take care of them. They do many things out of their own pockets. They pay for them themselves, or they get some donations, but nothing from the municipality. The municipality started with giving some food, but it's a little bit and not everybody gets it. The main problem here is that on this place is that all the cats, Nicole said it already, are sick. And what you do when you keep dumping kittens, they are all sick. You saw the kittens that we showed you, they are already sick.
Χρυσά, πες μας λίγο.
Λέει ότι συγκεκριμένα στην ΚΟΥ υπάρχουν 5 κτηνίατροι. Αλλά λέει είναι τόσο πολλές οι γάτες και οι κτηνίατροι δουλεύουν τόσο πολλές έξτρα ώρες που δεν γίνεται να στερωθούν όλες οι γάτες μόνο από αυτούς τους 5 κτηνίατρους. Λέει το Ασκληπίον είναι τα πιο σημαντικά αρχαιολογικά μνημεία και λέει το πρώτο πράγμα που βλέπουν τουρίστες όταν έρχονται είναι τις πολλές γάτες, άρρωστες, δεν είναι σε καλή κατάσταση, παρόλο που προσπαθούν να κάνουν τα πάντα για να είναι καλά, βγάζουν λεφτά από τη τσέπη τους, ταΐζουν, κάνουν ό,τι μπορούν και όταν μπορούν να τα πάνε στο κτηνίατρο, αλλά δεν μπορούν να λάβουν όλοι από μόνοι τους την ευθύνη.
Πρέπει
και ο Δήμαρχος να κάνει κάτι. Από ό,τι ξέρω, ο Δήμαρχος έχει αρχίσει να βοηθάει λίγο με τροφές, αλλά δεν είναι αρκετό.
So what happens is that local people, just like us, having jobs, like Grisa, there are many, many of us, believe us, foreigners living on Kos and Greek people from Kos having animals in our house. Believe me, that is not a good life. When you get a small kitten in your house, you have to bottle feed it every 2-3 hours, also in the night. It's a lot of work and it's very tiring next to your normal jobs. And especially when you don't get any backup, it's very frustrating. It's not a nice life to have that responsibility. So I have been looking also with other people for solutions, and one of the solutions would be organizations from outside of Kos, Greek organizations with licensed vet to work in Greece to help us. They want to come, they want to help catching cats, they want to help with castrations. It's only the municipality who has to supply them with a room where they can work. That's the only thing they ask. The municipality has those names, they has those contact details. They didn't do anything with it yet, and that's very frustrating for us. Yeah.
So officially you ask about this collaboration with an organization from Athens that has all the licenses and they can come here to help with you volunteering. And the only thing is that the mayor and the municipality have to help in this side to this direction and complete this volunteer activity.
Yes, they have to supply them with a room to work. That's the only thing they have to do. And all together we can have enough volunteers to help them catching and helping these organizations. But not in a lifetime it's possible to, with the 5 vets and the volunteers on Kos, to castrate all these cats. So this is what it is, kittens all over the place. And it's really not how it should be.
Είναι μια οργάνωση στην Αθήνα η οποία έχει κτηνιατρική άδεια και έχει έρθει σε επικοινωνία η Μαριέλα με τη συγκεκριμένη και είναι πρόθυμη να έρθουν στην ΚΟ να στηρώσουν τις γάτες. Απλά το μόνο που χρειάζεται είναι ο Δήμαρχος να έρθει σε επικοινωνία με τη συγκεκριμένη οργάνωση. Έχει τα τηλεφωνά τους, αλλά δεν έχετε κάνει τον κόπο να επικοινωνήσει μαζί τους. Και αυτό πρέπει να
τους βοηθήσει στην παραμονή τους στο νησί μας. Αυτό ουσιαστικά θέλουν. Για να έχουν κάπου να κοιμηθούν και κάπου να μπορέσουν να έρθουν να τους διευκολύνει το ταξίδι τους προς την ΚΟ. Γιατί φαντάζομαι θα έρθουν για ένα συγκεκριμένο χρονικό διάστημα. Αφού ολοκληρώσουν το έργο τους, θα ξαναεπιστρέψουν πάλι πίσω.
Ναι, το μόνο που πρέπει να κάνει ο Δήμος είναι να επικοινωνήσει μαζί τους, να τους δώσει κιόλας ένα χώρο που θα μπορούν να γίνονται στηρώσεις. Αυτό.
Yeah, I want to end with one thing, if that's possible. Yeah. If it's not for the animals, then please do it for all the local people here who care about animals, because it's not a nice life to have this responsibility and to have all these animals always in our care.
Αν ο Δήμος λέει δεν θέλει να το κάνει για τα ζώα, ας το κάνει για τους ντόπιους και τους ανθρώπους που είναι εδώ πέρα και κάνουν τα πάντα για να βοηθάνε αυτά τα ζώα. Γιατί είναι δύσκολο, είναι πολύ μεγάλη ευθύνη.